According to the research done by Forrester, up to 30% of e-commerce revenue is a result of upselling and cross-selling efforts. Hi, this is Vishal Kalia, and in this video, we are going to look at what is upselling and cross-selling for fashion retailer, strategies fashion retailers should be applying when upselling and cross-selling, and we are going to look at how Amazon and Zara does it, and one thing that Steve Madden's e-commerce website does that you should not be doing. So keep watching. So the first thing you need to know is that cross-selling and upselling are huge opportunities because you're selling to your existing customers who already like you and trust you. So let me repeat that. This is very, very important. That cross-selling and upselling are huge, huge, huge opportunities because you're selling to your existing customers. According to the research done by Groove, you are 14 times more likely to sell to an existing customer versus a new customer, as you can see in the graph right here. So how do you define upselling and cross-selling? So upselling is when a retailer encourages a customer towards a higher priced alternative. So think about subscription-based websites such as, you know, Tote or Stitch Fix or Dollar Shave Club or Birch Box, or if one first tier, which is might be a small priced tier, $5, $10 per month, then the second and the third tier could be more expensive tiers as $20 or $30. So when a retailer is encouraging the user to opt to the next tier, they're trying to upsell more services and better packaging. So number two is cross-selling. So what is cross-selling? A cross-selling is when you recommend a product or products to customer that complements their current purchase. So think about like bundling items. So think about when you are a retailer and you're just selling a shirt. So rather than selling just the shirt, you are selling the customer the whole look, which includes a jacket, pair of socks, shoes, pants, or whatnot. So now this is cross-selling, when you are telling your customers that these are the complementary products based on whatever single item that they have selected. So how to upsell in retail and upselling strategies inspired by Amazon and Steve Madden. According to data provided by Amazon in 2006, 36% of its revenue was a result of upselling and cross-selling efforts. So what are the strategies that Amazon uses on its website that we can take inspiration from? So the first one is create scarcity. You know, FOMO, the fear of missing out, upsell with an element of scarcity will get people into the buying mode. So when you search for a product at Amazon, you can immediately see how many are left, and there's a very good call to action right next to it. And this is pretty powerful persuasion, because if the product is adding value to the customer and you know that they're left, the likelihood of customer to jump on the particular product and add to their cart is much more likely than any other alternative. The second is color psychology. Your studies have shown that we click on blue colored links more than any other color. According to the study by Fast Company, color is behind 90% of the assessment of a product. So choosing the right color will help you to persuade people to click on the buy button. So if you look at Amazon, every single clickable link that they have on their site is in blue, and the pricing is in red, so it does in contrast and stands out. And they never give you one price, they always give you a range of pricing. So it makes you curious that I want to click on this button and take a look at what is the range of pricing is available, and it increases the likelihood of a customer to their cart. Is increase perceived value by bundling things together. So if you want to sell more of your products and services, increase their perceived value by offering different bundles. It works well for an online retailer to build on a natural human behavior of getting value, real or perceived. Number four is build trust. Customers buy from people they trust, and people trust other people more than they trust the retailers. So that's a social proof. So Amazon uses 5-star rating for all of their products. Steve Madden also allows customers to add reviews for the product. So let's look at some examples of upselling. So let's look at Spotify, for example. If you go and click on their pricing, they give you two options. One is the Spotify free, and the second is Spotify premium. The free is $0, the premium is $9.99. And as you can see the way it's laid out, the free one, even though they don't offer like 5 or 6 of the features, they actually still list them, but they're actually grayed out. So the customer comes and sees and they're like, okay, only the shuffle play is available. But if I want ad-free, unlimited skips, you know, listen offline, all this stuff, then I can move into the paid version. So they are upselling customers into the paid version by listing the features that they are missing in the free version and the one they will get in the paid version. So looking at Spotify's example, what can you learn from it as a fashion retailer? So think about if you have a subscription-based model, so like the Tote or Stitch Fix or Ipsy, as we talked about, free version or the cheaper version, and list all the features that the customer is missing in that particular version. And if they buy the next tier, so typically companies have at least three tiers. So if they go to the second or the third tier, they will have these features as part of it. So as a fashion retailer or even as a fashion subscription model website, you can use Spotify's layout and actually upsell customers into the tier number two for your subscription or tier three. So another type of business that you can do this is an item that customers buys on a regular basis. So let's say, for example, you are a retailer, but you only sell undergarments or undershirts or shaving razors. You know, the customer is going to buy on a regular basis. So maybe they buy, you know, three pairs of undergarments every 3 months. So, and each undergarment probably costs them, like, say, $20. So you can offer a subscription model to your existing customers that, hey, if you sign up into our model or subscribe to our newer model, we will send you three pairs of undergarments every 3 months. And if it's costing you $20 right now to buy it, but if you get on our subscription plan, it will only cost you 10 or 15 bucks. So the benefits to you is you actually get a regular customer with a recurring revenue. And the benefit for the customer is now they don't have there, because this is the product they are going to buy anyway. Now they don't have to log in and order every time, and they're saving $5 to $10 on each particular item. So it's a win-win for both of them. Example is Express. So Express offers a volume discounts, like buy this shirt and get the second one for $10 or $19.99. So you can create these type of bundles for your customers to actually get them to purchase more. So let's look at another example is free shipping. In this day and age, nobody wants to pay for shipping. So Zara does this really well. So their regular item, let's say, costs around 50 bucks. But if you place an order of more than $70, you get free shipping. So you can use this technique by offering your customers free shipping if they upgrade or buy another item to complement their existing product. So now customer gets free shipping and you get additional revenue. So let's look at cross-selling. Cross-selling is when you recommend a product or a collection of products to a customer that complements their current purchase. You should know that cross-selling was shown to be much more effective when presented on the checkout pages versus the product page. So retailers that use cross-selling often display recommended products or services that were purchased by another customer who bought the same item, basically introduce customers to complementary products. So what are the benefits of cross-selling? Cross-selling is a great way to not only increase conversions rate, but also to build customer loyalty. It helps differentiate your brand from other competitors and improve your market position. So how and when to use cross-selling? So one of the most effective cross-selling tactics is bundling and saving packs. That is, you offer multiple complementary products at a lower bargain rate. So think of Costco bundles. You know, this approach helps boost the amount of money spent on one order. Another way to cross-sell your products or services is by recommending to your customers which other purchases were made by those. A simple message such as, customers who bought this also bought this, can help you increase your conversion rate. You know, you can take this even one step further by taking the cross-selling method and getting customers to personalize their bundles by selecting the exact products they want instead of stuck with anything that they don't want to need. So let's look at a couple examples. So Costco bundles, as I mentioned, is one of the big ones. So if you're buying a PlayStation game, the console might cost you $400, but if you couple it with like two games and a couple other packages, you can get the whole thing for $600, who would have cost you like $800 to $900 the other way otherwise. You know, another example is Zara. So when you go to Zara, you select a piece of it. As you scroll down, they give you a section which is called Wear With, and it's a great way to suggest other items that would help complement that look for a particular customer. You know, Gap is another big example, especially if you have a physical store. Like, using the mannequins to sell complimentary products can work really wonders. I go to a Gap store and I'm just looking for a shirt. I'm like, maybe it works, maybe it doesn't for me. But when I see it, put it together on a mannequin with the right pair of jeans, socks, shoes, you know, a jacket and a scarf, then I'm much more likely to picture myself in that particular look and might as well buy the whole look versus just one particular. Cross-selling works really, really well. But how do you implement cross-selling and upselling on your particular website? You know, this cannot be manually done. It has to be automated. So if you have a Shopify store, it's actually pretty easy. You can go to apps.shopify.com and search for product upsell, and they give you multiple apps that you, with one click, you can implement it and you can have it live running on your Shopify store and test it accordingly to see which one works better for you. So I went to Steve Madden's website. You know, I clicked on a shoe, I really liked it, so I wanted to buy one. So the minute I clicked to add it to cart, it started showing me other shoes that looked very similar to the one that I just bought, and it said, you may also like that. To me, that's not really a good strategy, because I just spent $200 buying a pair of shoes and now you're showing me another one that in the same shoe category that I'm much more likely to just ignore. But the better way for you to cross-sell this product would be that if you compliment a pair of socks or another items to keep my shoes clean, I would actually much more likely to add those as part of my purchase rather than adding another shoe or another $200 item. So this is something I would not recommend you doing. So what should you pick? Should you pick cross-sell, upsell, or both? In my personal experience, it depends on what kind of business you have. So let's say if you are a fashion retailer or fashion designer, it makes much more sense for you to do cross-selling versus upselling. So for example, let's say because cross-selling allows you to put together a complete look and you can sell complementary products. So if somebody just added a shirt or a dress on your site, you can add a pair of shoes or create a complete look, and that's complimentary products, and the person is much more likely to add those as part of their cart versus trying to sell them another piece of dress or another shirt that's something that they just bought. But that said, if you have a subscription type of website, which would be something like Tote or Stitch Fix or Ipsy or Birch Box, so those type of models, you will probably have 1 to 3 tiers that the customer can pick. So at that time, it makes much more sense to have an upselling strategy. Bring the customer in through the basic or the free model, and then upsell them on the second or the third tier, which is more expensive but actually adds more value. So if the customer is already using your free tier and he actually knows who you are, likes your product, their likelihood of jumping into the next tier, the more expensive tier, is much more higher. So as cross-selling and upselling can help you increase your revenue, find out what type of business you are in and which makes sense for you, and mix and match them. You know, try cross-selling and upselling together and see which generates more revenue for you, more click-throughs for you, and pick accordingly. So hi, this is Vishal Kalia from Fashion Marketing. And if you like this video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you have any questions regarding upselling and cross-selling, leave them in the form of the comment and I will be more than happy to answer. So thank you very much for your time and have a wonderful day.